is Russell High School Sports on greenabeacon.com. This live video streaming webcast is an exclusive presentation by the Green of Beacon and First and People's Bank and Trust. Russell Sports Action is also brought to you by Ohio University Southern, Our Lady of Bellefonte Hospital, Carmen Funeral Home, Stultz Pharmacy, Meredith Chiropractic, Ashland Community and Technical College, and the Sungate Alpaca Company. Russell Sports on greenabeacon.com and its webcast team, Hank Bond, Keith Adkins, Brittany Hoback, Ryan Yearout, Evan Tice, and Kristen Keaton. This is Russell High School Sports on greenabeacon.com. And good evening, everybody. Welcome to Boyd County High School, or actually Boyd County Middle School tonight, for tonight's ball game between the Boyd County Lions, 17-3 on the year, and the Russell Red Devils coming into tonight's contest, 5-16. Russell with a good outing against Round County last week, played probably their best four quarters of ball of the year as they pulled down to kept them even through three, and had with 3 minutes to go, we're still well in it. A couple of missed opportunities, and Round County won it by 10. Boyd County, on the other hand, had a game last night against the Rose Hill Royals, and both girls and boys had big wins, but nonetheless, it is time for tonight's game. We're here at Boyd County Middle School in Summit. Hank Bond, along with the live stream technician Keith Adkins, who will also have a mic on tonight, and we'll be back here in just a couple of minutes to get ready. The teams are leaving the floor. I guess we're probably ready for the national anthem coming up here in just a moment here on greenabeacon.com and greenabeacon2.com, as it's Russell and Boyd County here on your live streaming network here in Eastern Kentucky. Thank you for joining us. It's a great opportunity to be covering both these teams. We do cover Russell on greenabeacon.com, and we cover Boyd County. Keith Adkins and Kristen Keaton, they cover Boyd County on greenabeacon2.com. On mixed games as this is, we choose to come to these together. I don't know, are we going to do the national anthem, you think, before the clock runs down like they do at Russell, or do they wait till they come back out?
Normally they'll wait till they come back out.
Okay, all right. So we'll step away here for a couple minutes. We thank you for joining us. This is Russell and Boyd County Basketball on Green and Beacon.
First and People's Bank has six convenient locations to serve you, from South Shore to the main office. First and People's Bank has been serving this area with complete banking services since 1932. Visit the home office near you. First and People's Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
We are the home office. Come visit any of our six locations.
I go to Ashland Community and Technical College
because it's so close.
I go
for the small class sizes.
I go
because I can transfer my credits.
I go because
I can take classes when it works for me.
I go to get a better job.
I go for some of Kentucky's most affordable tuition.
I go because it's crazy not to.
For all the right reasons, Ashland Community and Technical College. Higher education begins here.
Visit the Sungate Alpaca Company to experience the vibrant cultural heritage of South America and discover the extraordinary luxury fabric called alpaca. Wrap yourself in a stylish alpaca scarf. Transform your living room by adding texture and color with a hand-loomed alpaca throw blanket, and add a little extra warmth and cozy fashion with an alpaca hat and matching gloves. Visit sungatealpaca.com for all your alpaca needs. Find us on Facebook for special deals and inventory updates. Shop Sungate Alpaca.
The fine people at Carmen Funeral Home have been working with families in need for over 100 years. Carmen Funeral Home offers compassionate and caring services to those in their time of need, from pre-arrangement to final arrangements. With two convenient locations in Flatwoods and Russell, Carmen Funeral Home, putting people first since 1913.
Of Boyd County with a 70-44 win at Russell earlier in the season. As the Red Devils come back out on the floor, 3 minutes, 30 seconds away from our national anthem, as we see across the way the ROTC here at Boyd County High School. They'll we're at the middle school for the game tonight, but it is the Boyd County High School ROTC, as they'll present the colors for our national anthem here on the floor at Boyd County Middle. Some exciting basketball is taking place here. Lots of regional championships for the last, though, for Boyd County was in 2000. And they also won it in 99 and 98. As I look across there, 95, they were regional champs. 94, 90, 84, 82, 81, and 1973, year after Russell won it in 1972. Steve Toler, who graduated here in 1963, actually taught high school when I was a freshman, or when I was a senior, his first year, he was at Russell. Phil Pratt, several jerseys have been hung in the rafters as they are honored. Frank Lee, some really quality ball players here at Boyd County High School. 2 minutes away from the national anthem and then the announcement of our starting lineups. We'll be back here in a couple minutes. This is Russell and Boyd County Basketball on Green & Beacon and GreenandBeacon2.com.
I'm Julie Reeves. You're watching Green at Beacon.com, a member of the Beacon Media Group.
The force, it's got a lot of power, and it makes me feel like it.
Russell and Boyd County Boys Basketball from Boyd County Middle School in Summit has the ROTC young men line up down to our left. I think they're all young men tonight. And there is one young lady in, and they'll be announced here. And we'll step away for the public address announcer here on GreenandBeacon.com.
Hi, this is Brittany Hoback, and you're watching greenupbeacon.com.
Our patients are priority number one. For the seventh straight year, Our Lady of Bellefonte Hospital has received Health Grade's Outstanding Patient Experience Award, and the hospital continues to be placed in the top 5% in the nation for outstanding patient experience. Our Lady of Bellefonte Hospital says thank you to our patients for this People's Choice honor. Our Lady of Bellefonte Hospital, on a mission for good health for you and your family.
As we're ready now for our good tip-off. And for Boyd County, it's Rousey, Anderson, Evans, Thobson, and Gauz. For Russell on the floor, we see Stump, Hensley, Brewer, Hale, and Raby. Thobson jumps it up against Stump. Boyd County controls it. We're underway. From Summit Middle School, Hank Bond and Keith Adkins. Glad to have you with us here. As the Lions have it first on offense, Evans with it down in the corner, comes back out top to Anderson. Down inside it goes, they'll dribble her back out. That was Evans inside. Anderson on the left side to Rousey. Anderson takes it, stolen away Stump, bounced off of Evans, and then it went off Stump as he tried to bounce it to save it for Russell. And nonetheless, it becomes Boyd County's ball. Lions sets some offense out front. That's Rousey out front. Kicks it right side to Anderson. They pick him up. No shot. Rousey. Anderson. Thobson. Three. We're underway. 7:25. 3-0 Boyd County. Raby comes in to Stump. Full court pressure from Boyd County. Randy Anderson. See, it's Bobby Anderson's the player. Randy's the coach. I'll get it before the game's over. Hensley, left side to Hale. Hale comes across. Evans cuts him off right at midcourt, gives it back to Hensley. Hale still on defense. He's getting the call. He'll get, if he doesn't drive in, he'll get a five count. And he's on the baseline. Looks, try to kick it out. Stolen away. Evans is going to be a foul called on Stump. So it'll be a quick foul on Ryan Stump to get things underway. And on the common foul, Boyd County will play it in right down to our left. As we're on the mezzanine level here at Boyd County High School on the visitor side. Not a big crowd on hand tonight, kind of a cold Tuesday night here in Summit. In the lane, Gauz took too many steps, no call, did a walk again, laid it up and in. So two walks by Gauz, he gets a bucket. So they're going to let him play a little bit tonight. He had some fancy footwork inside. Cross it comes, going to be stolen away almost, and Stump picks it up. He took a step. Raby brings it across. He went, did not take the ball across. Head it comes to Hale. Last touch by Thobson, and it'll be Russell's ball. 5-0, Boyd County with a quick lead. 6:15 to play, first quarter. Raby looks to throw it in, does, and then comes in to Hensley. He'll run the point. Hale over on the right side, looks to go underneath, does. He comes across. He's picked up down inside. Raby with three, and it's 5-3 from the top of the key. 6:02 to play. stolen away inside. Russell has it. Hale brings it up. Red Devils can tie it. Hale gets some pressure from Rousey. Turnover Russell. Anderson dumps it in the lane. Gauze, he walks. It should be a 3 second count. They don't wing it off, and it comes over to Anderson. Rebound stump in front of Gauze. Nice play there by Gauze. I stayed off his back, but there's going to be a foul called on Thovzen as Hensley went to the floor. And on the common foul, it'll be Russell's ball. Both teams with foul. And it's 5:28 to play in quarter one. What do you think, Coach? We okay?
Got it under control, man.
Across the top, Hale all the way down. Shoots it high, no good. Rebound. Last touch. Nope, Boyd County got it. Rousey with the back out to Anderson. Evans back to Anderson. Kind of runs the point out there. They're not coming out on him too hard. Gauze double teamed down on the baseline. There's a three from Lefty. Thovzen no good, but it's rebounded nicely by Rousey. He'll give it to Anderson. Kicks back to Rousey. No good, back of the rim. And the rebounded is Anderson. Merrill Kidwell wants a little action under the boards by the Red Devils, and it goes to Gauze. He wants to turn on Stump. He does. He draws a foul, gets a bucket. 7-3 and a chance to make it 8-3 for Gauze. Connor Gauze at 6-3. Hefty on the inside. I think we're in pretty good shape, Coach. Keith Atkins on the camera for you. 8-3. Silas Cox checks in. To the bench goes Stump. Two fouls on Stump. Two fouls on the Red Devils. Raby comes in to Hensley. Raby keeps it. Back to Hensley. Full court pressure applied by the Lions. Raby gets it over to Hale. Hale drives. Gives it to Brewer off the glass and in. Nice play down on the baseline. Some heads up play. That's Evans with it right in front of us. Out front is Rousey. He goes over to Thovzen. Gauze. Just kind of around the perimeter a little bit. 8-5. Boyd County by three. 3:39 to play first quarter. Thovzen cross courts it to Anderson. Some pressure from Raby. And it goes out on the right-hand side. Gauze. Anderson had a look, gives it on the baseline. Thovzen comes out, going to be over and back. So how long is your boy out?
11. So go 11. Back. He started therapy, so he'll be back the 11th.
And Amir will be back on the 11th. At least we hope. If he can manage not to twist it again, right? Hunter Priest in for Boyd County. Shot up, no good.
Burnett also come in.
Seth?
Burnett.
Burnett.
Last game, Tanner Evans, assist for Rousey.
Evans with the shot, makes it 10-5. And Tyler Burnett is out also for Boyd County. Burnett underneath, throws it up, knocked down, it was touched. Raby will bring it all the way, takes it against Evan. Can't control it. Out of bounds, last touch by Boyd County, and that was touched by Priest. And with that, 10-5. And Russell with a chance to cut into the Boyd County lead. If Cox can get it in, he does, to Hensley. From the corners, see, that's Raby missed a three. We'll see Hunter Williams check in. Spent some time with Billy Williams, Hunter's grandpa, yesterday afternoon at the Russell Hall of Fame. We're going to have a whistle, a foul on the floor. Be a common foul as they try to originate a athletic Hall of Fame. Try to get things underway. Have nominations. It'll be interesting. For Boyd County, it's Brock Dameron. Anderson keys it in to Burnett. Tossed around out front. Priest with it. Back to Burnett. With it. They're from downtown. Going to miss it all. Air ball there by Dameron. And it's 10-5 and a turnover on the missed shot as it went out of bounds. And so on the team rebound, Russell gets it back. Cox looks. Comes in to Landon Brewer. Cox one-on-one, bounce pass ahead to Hensley. He walked, got away with it. Cox from the left side for three, right it down. It's 10-8. Ball blocked twice. Up no good. Rebound comes off to Hunter Williams. They gave that three to Hale, but I thought it was Cox. Nonetheless, Brewer tied up at 10-10, 1:42 to play. On the Brewer putback. So we're tied at 10. Boyd County had an early lead and has led pretty much from the onset. Brewer picked that ball up off the floor and had a straight shot up to the basket. Gauze picked up by Williams. Ball comes out. Burnett. Boyd County looking to knock one down here. Here's a three. No good. Air ball. We're going to have a foul against. Foul's called on Hunter Priest. On the rebound, the push foul. Common foul gives the ball to Russell. Raby checks in, and to the bench will go Hensley. We're tied at 10, 107 to play. Three fouls on Russell, two on Boyd County. Hale with it. In the corner, Williams. He gets picked up by Gauze, double team now. Over there on him is Dameron. And the ball is last touched. It'll be Boyd County's ball. Burnett into Anderson, and Anderson will bring it across the timeline. Boys varsity action. Lions with the ball. Randy Anderson's team performing pretty well at 17-3. Talked to Merle Kidwell before the game. He feels his team has come 100 miles since the first game. One from downtown, right that down. That's a three for Anderson. And it's 13-10 now as the Lions have taken the lead back after Russell had come back to tie it at 10. Hale to Cox, back to Hale. Hale brings it down. He wanted the shot, didn't get it. Picked up by Anderson. Nice defense there by Bobby. Three-pointer up, no good. Rebound pushed up. That'll end one. So at end of one, it's Boyd County 13 and Russell 10. We'll be back in a minute here on greenatbeacon.com.
Choosing the right college is a big decision. Ohio University Southern offers more than 30 degree and certificate programs. Whether you're in Ohio or just across the river in Kentucky or West Virginia, our tuition is a best value in the area. Attend a world-class university and stay close to home with free parking. Ohio University Southern in Ironton and Proctorville. Imagine your possibilities. Enroll today. Visit ohio.edu/southern or call 740-533-4600.
At Meredith Chiropractic, you will enjoy state-of-the-art chiropractic facilities and discover the true wellness lifestyle. Dr. Terry Meredith is a member of Great Doctors of Chiropractic and has helped many in the Ashland area experience natural healing without surgery or drugs. If you're looking for a skilled chiropractic doctor, visit MeredithChiropractic.com, call 329-8158, or visit Dr. Meredith's office at 2120 Carter Avenue in Ashland.
13-10, Russell trails Boyd County as the Lions work away from a 10-10 tie with 1:42 to play. And at the end of one, Russell by three, or Boyd County by three. Inside it goes to Brewer. Brewer can't get rid of it, does. Gets it back to Hale. Into Brewer in the lane. He'll bounce it out. There's Williams on the baseline. Williams with a nice shot, and it's 13-12. Hunter Williams adds a bucket for Russell, and the Lions will look to add to their lead. Ashland trailing East Carter 22-9 at the first stop. East Carter liable to put another loss on Buddy Biggs and the Tomcats. Evans, Anderson in the corner to Rousey. Starting five on the floor for Boyd County. Stump is out. Hensley is out for Russell. Baseline shot up, no good. On the inside, we're going to have a foul. Foul called on, looks like on Connor Gauze. And it'll be Russell's ball. I'm sorry, it was on Tanner Evans. Gauze looked at the official. I thought the call was on him. Gravy ahead, it comes to Hale. Hale brings it down, three on two. Hale with the basket. Gauze caused him to alter the shot as he went for the ball. He fouled. A little frustration foul there. And that'll be four fouls on Russell, 13-12. And Boyd County will play the ball left to right the full length of the court on the common foul. One foul on Hale. As I said, two on Stump. Evans going to draw a foul from Brewer. It'll be a common foul. I thought he knocked the ball away. Nice move there. Hensley in for Hale. Out front, that's Evans. Anderson to Rousey, back to Evans. Russell sags around a little bit. Gauze top at the free throw line. Gives it back to Anderson. Here's three from Rousey, no good. Rebound nicely by Thoveson. He kicks it back out. Gauze with it, but it'll come back out around the outer circle. Cross court, it comes to Evans. Unopposed three there by Rousey, no good. We're gonna walk the floor as Thoveson picks up the foul. That'll be five on Boyd County, two on the big Thorson, who is a sophomore, or I'm sorry, is a senior for Boyd County. Henderson gets it ahead. Hunter Williams all the way down, lays it up and in. Two baskets for Williams. Russell with a 14-13 lead. Rebound inside, no good. Out of bounds off of Brewer. So with 5:51 to play in the half, Russell took a 14-13 lead on a Williams layup. And they've stayed close. Inside it goes. They tried to loft the ball to Gauze. It'll go ahead to Williams. Williams stops, turns back around. Anderson picks him up. He's triple teamed over there. They give it to Raby. He puts it up and in. And it's 16-13, Russell. 5:25 on the Raby put up. Evans over to Anderson. Anderson out front. Rousey, he had a shot, but he tried to go inside. Anderson will shoot from three, write that down, and that ties it at 16. With 5 minutes even to play, Brewer with it. He'll bring it across the timeline. Stolen away as he tried to give it up. Shot up and in by Evans. He draws a foul. And with the foul, that'll make it six on Russell. Actually, seven on Russell, I think. So Evans gets the bucket. Taylor Smith is out for Boyd County. And with that, does not, but it's rebounded inside by Gauze, who fits it back and in. And so it becomes 20-16 with 4:40 to play. Pressure put on. Hensley can't handle it. I thought we might see a timeout there, but Coach Kidwell, I think, is going to let it just continue. Anderson. Inside, shot up and in.
Basket by Connor Gauze.
So Gauze with the basket gives Boyd County a 6-point lead. Foul on the way up the floor on defense. See Dalton Duvall, he'll check in. Silas Cox will go to the bench. Duvall will go down on the inside. Boyd County will drop back off the press. Six fouls against Russell, five against Boyd County. Boyd County with one to give. Double team out on the top of the press. They tried to bounce it to Duvall, but Gauze was quick enough. And with the ball, Anderson, one hand pass to the left. Up, no good. Rebound inside Gauze. He has nowhere to go with it. He backed out of there, and the rebound comes off to Raby. Smith unable to get his shot to go down either. Inside baseline, Hunter Williams. Backed around, knocked around, picked up last touch by Williams as he tried to get the ball back out front. And with 3:49 to play, Boyd County 6 points up and with the ball. Round the circle it goes, Smith to Anderson, into Gauze. Spin around, Gauze with a right-handed straight-on jump hook, no good. Ball out of bounds, and it'll be Russell's ball. Stump checks in. Hunter Williams to the bench. Burnett in for Boyd County, and Hunter Priest in for the Lions. Raby walked. He got a break there. Hale ahead to Raby. He dumps it to Stump. Stump down the lane. Gives it off to Duvall. He's fouled as he goes up. He's fouled inside there by Zach Webb. First one up. No good. I may have the wrong name for three. I'm not sure. Second one, no good. Rebound comes off to Boyd County, and Anderson will bring it. Quickly up the floor, it comes to Smith over there. Anderson from NBA three range, no good. Stump pulls it down, gives it to Hensley. Russell runs. Quickly ahead it comes to Raby, a wide open three, no good, rebound, and have a foul on the inside. And it's be one and one as we walk the floor.
And we'll get to Russell number 10, Silas Cox.
Cox in, the ball to the bench. What's his last name?
Kinzer.
Hunter Kinzer. I have it right now. Hits it. And he'll get the bonus. 23-16 Boyd County. No good. So a 7-point lead. Russell with the ball. Lid kind of shut for Russell. Raby from three. Write it down. 23-19. So we're down to a 4-point Boyd County lead, but the Lions with the ball. Spark plug Anderson out with it out front. Token defense by Russell with 2:33 to play in the half. We'll have at our half, Pete Fraley. Anderson drives, kicks it out, unopposed three. Smith back of the rim, rebound inside, up and in by Kinzer. And that'll make it 25-19, back to a 6-point lead. Russell breaks the press, ahead to Hale. Hale from three, no good. Rebound comes off to Burnett. All the way down, Smith on the fast break, no good. Put back up and in, though, by Kinzer. And it's an 8-point lead for Boyd County as the Lions' two quick baskets have given them the advantage. Stump all the way down in the corner. Triple team throws it out front. Saved over on the other side by Cox. Stolen. Last touch by Smith. And it'll be Gauze and Dameron. Yes, we'll check back in for Russell. Out will be Priest and Anderson. Raby out, Hunter Williams back in. 27-19, timeout on the floor. We'll be back in a minute. This is Russell Basketball on greenandbeacon.com.
First and People's Bank has six convenient locations to serve you. From South Shore to the main office, First and People's Bank has been serving this area with complete banking services since 1932. Visit the home office near you. First and People's Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
We are the home office. Come visit any of our six locations.
First and People's Bank.
I go to Ashland Community and Technical College.
Because it's so close.
I go.
For the small class sizes.
I go. Because I can transfer my credits.
I go. Because
I can take classes when it works for me.
I go. To get a better job.
I go for some of Kentucky's most affordable tuition.
I go because it's crazy not to.
For all the right reasons, Ashland Community and Technical College. Higher education begins here.
Back out with it. Shot up, no good. Williams steps on the line out of bounds, so the shot by Cox missed it all. And after the timeout, Boyd County with an 8-point lead in the ball, 1:18 to play here in the first half. East Carter leads Ashland 31-19 with 4:02 to play. That's the only other game I have scores on. Shot no good. Rebound Hale. He's fouled by Burnett. And that'll send Russell to the free throw line. East Carter with a 9-10 mark. Ashland is 1-20 on the year. Rematch of the consolation bracket in the AIT this year. Lewis County faces Estill County in the old high school gym. And that's what I have for scores. Free throw no good. Got to hit them when the clock stops. 50 seconds to play. Burnett with it out front. Cross courts it to Gauze. Run this one down. Kinzer over to Gauze. 25 seconds to play in the first half. Smith, right side goes. Here's a three. No good. Another short one comes up. Dameron gets his own rebound, lays it in. And timeout, Russell. That's a 10-point lead with 13.9 seconds to play. We'll be back in a minute.
Visit the Sungate Alpaca Company to experience the vibrant cultural heritage of South America and discover the extraordinary luxury fabric called alpaca. Wrap yourself in a stylish alpaca scarf. Transform your living room by adding texture and color with a hand-loomed alpaca throw blanket, and add a little extra warmth and cozy fashion with an alpaca hat and matching gloves. Visit sungatealpaca.com for all your alpaca needs. Find us on Facebook for special deals and inventory updates. Shop Sungate Alpaca.
Ten seconds to play. Russell with the ball. Hensley, a jumper, hits the front of the rim, comes off, tapped around. Stump gets it. 3 seconds, puts it up. No good. Rebound. Connor Gauze, and that'll end the half as Gauze just flings it to the other end. So we're at the end of the first half. Russell trails Boyd County by a score of 29-19, a 16-9 quarter in favor of those Boyd County Lions. And we'll step away and be back here in a couple of minutes. We'll have Pete Fraley coming up to visit with us, the girls coach from Boyd County. And we also have some young ladies out on the floor. I'd say we'll have a little cheerleader activity. We'll be back here where Boyd County leads Russell from Summit Middle School 29-19 at intermission. We'll be back here on Greener Beacon and GreenerBeacon2.com. Twenty-nine, 19. Boyd County leads Russell here at intermission at Boyd County Middle School at Summit Middle School. Is it Summit Middle School?
Boyd County Middle School.
Boyd County Middle School. Our guest here is Pete Fraley, the girls' head basketball coach and athletic director, and also coordinates concessions for the media and anything else that goes on. What do you call it? Hospitality rooms.
Well, we do that for district region tournaments.
So, Pete, let's talk a little bit. Your team, do you feel like you've gotten better since the beginning of the year?
Yeah, we have. We've gotten better each and every day. We're nowhere near where we need to be to compete for a district or regional title, but we're getting better, and we've still got about 3 weeks to go, and we're starting to tighten things up a little bit.
So now, is your district here?
Yes, it is.
Are you going to play it here or out at the...
We're going to play... Fairview has the boys, and we have the girls, and they're going to bring the boys here, so we're going to play both of them
right
here at the middle school.
Now, our plan is to be here for that, so hopefully it'll be an exciting night with a lot of people and a lot of noise, and I'm sure you'd like to notch a couple wins over that.
Absolutely. Well, we need to get the first one. That's the main one. We get the first one, and we've punched our ticket to Moorhead. But to get two here would be really nice.
So what are you working on now, Pete? What are you trying to accomplish at this point in the season?
Well, we've thrown some different things at different people that we think are teams that we would have to beat in order to get to a region championship. And we're just trying to lock those things down, tighten up a few things. And then you also want to try to put in a few different variations to your offense, because everybody scouts you and they know what you're going to run. So we just want to have a few things in our back pocket when we need them.
And you've got your daughter plays, and you've got – how many seniors do you put on the floor to start?
She's the only one. We have another senior who just came out this year. She doesn't get a whole lot of playing time. She missed about 4 weeks of practice right at the beginning of the season. She's just never been able to catch up. But Shireen is a wonderful girl. She never complains, and she comes and busts her tail and she makes the other kids better. And, you know, that's what it's all about.
Well, you know, we, of course, we stream a lot of games during the season. And to be real honest with you, you know, on any given night, there's five, six ball clubs can win the 16th region this year.
Absolutely. There's a lot of parity. I mean, of course, you have Ashland East Carter, who everybody considers to be out in front right now. And I throw Lewis County right up there, too. They have a nice team. They're very dangerous. You know, you look around, you've got Russell, Fleming, Rowan, Bath. Those teams that can beat anybody on any given night.
I saw, I see where Bath County kind of is hitting its click just a little bit right now. They've got the girl back, and they got the Flowers girl, who's a real young player who will be an all-star wherever she plays.
She's a nice player, and then you got Sarah. And Troy Lee does a really good job with them, and yeah, we want to wish them luck in the All-A Classic. I think they play Wednesday morning against Caverna. But Troy does a great job. He scouts. He gets out, marks his tail off, and he has his kids prepared.
And I believe the All-A's at the Exposition Center in Frankfurt this year.
It's at the Frankfurt Convention Center. Wonderful place to watch a basketball game. My first year of coaching, that's where the state tournament was, and it was an incredible atmosphere. The state tournament has grown and outgrown that venue, but I really enjoy watching a game there.
I can tell you that I was the sports information director at Kentucky State for 2 years, and that was before they built the Exum Center on the hill, so we played all our games there. I tell you what, nothing like about 7,000 in there in two bands and standing in the end zone. It could get rowdy.
That's a nice atmosphere for kids to play in.
We'll be back with Coach Fraley here in just a minute. You're watching Russell and Boyd County Basketball on Green at Beacon and greenatbeacon2.com.
Our patients are priority number one. For the seventh straight year, Our Lady of Bellefonte Hospital has received HealthGrades Outstanding Patient Experience Award, and the hospital continues to be placed in the top 5% in the nation for outstanding patient experience. Our Lady of Bellefonte Hospital says thank you to our patients for this People's Choice honor. Our Lady of Bellefonte Hospital, on a mission for good health for you and your family.
Stoltz Pharmacy is now offering patients compounding for their prescription needs. Stoltz Pharmacy is the only pharmacy in the area that is PCCA certified. We can provide you with hormone replacement, neuropathy creams, scar creams, pediatric prescriptions, and we can even help you with your veterinarian needs. If you have any questions, please call 606-834-1052. That's 834-1052. Stoltz Pharmacy in Greenup, Flatwoods, and Wheelersburg. More than you expect from a pharmacy.
Stoltz Pharmacy.
29-19, the Boyd County Lions lead the Russell Red Devils. We're at half, and a couple more questions here for Coach Pete Fraley, the girls' coach and athletic director in Boyd County. And Coach, as you look into the regional tournament, as a head basketball coach, what do you try to do? Do you try to fine-tune what you work on all season? Is that how you, when you go into the district? I mean, you can't make big changes, really.
No, not a lot of drastic changes, but you do fine-tune what you've got. And like I said, we'll have a play or two in our back pocket, a go-to play late, because by now everybody's scouting you and they know what your best play is going to be. So you've got to have something to counteract that.
Pete, I want to thank you for letting us come and do your ball games. I think it's great for the kids and great for the community to have a voice for Russell and for Boyd County. And, who knows, next year we may add some more. But I credit you for helping us get all this done.
Hey, I appreciate you guys coming and taking care of our kids.
Thanks, Pete. Good luck. When we get to the big time, good luck.
Thank you.
See ya.
video streaming webcast is an exclusive presentation by the Green at Beacon and First and People's Bank and Trust. Russell Sports Action is also brought to you by Ohio University Southern, Our Lady of Bellefonte Hospital, Carmen Funeral Home, Stultz Pharmacy, Meredith Chiropractic, Ashland Community and Technical College, and the Sungate Alpaca Company. Russell Sports on greenatbeacon.com and its webcast team, Hank Bond, Keith Adkins, Brittany Hoback, Ryan Uralt, Evan Tice, and Kristen Keaton. This is the fine people at Carmen Funeral Home have been working with families in need for over 100 years. Carmen Funeral Home offers compassionate and caring services to those in their time of need, from pre-arrangement to final arrangements. With two convenient locations in Flatwoods and Russell, Carmen Funeral Home, putting people first since 1913.
Our patients are priority number one. For the seventh straight year, Our Lady of Bellefonte Hospital has received HealthGrades Outstanding Patient Experience Award, and the hospital continues to be placed in the top 5% in the nation for outstanding patient experience. Our Lady of Bellefonte Hospital says thank you to our patients for this People's Choice honor. Our Lady of Bellefonte Hospital, on a mission for good health for you and your family.
Stultz Pharmacy is now offering patients compounding for their prescription needs. Stultz Pharmacy is the only pharmacy in the area that is PCCA certified. We can provide you with hormone replacement, neuropathy creams, scar creams, pediatric prescriptions, and we can even help you with your veterinarian needs. If you have any questions, please call 606-834-1052. That's 834-1052. Stultz Pharmacy in Greenup, Flatwoods, and Wheelersburg. More than you expect from a pharmacy.
Stultz Pharmacy.
Stultz Pharmacy is now offering patients
29-19. Boyd County with the lead here at Summit Middle School. Boyd County Middle School in Summit, that's the way you say it. Hank Bond along with Keith Atkins, as both teams are now back out after a little bit of halftime with some cheerleaders and some great opportunities for young people to perform on a broader stage here in the big gym. I've been here for a few pretty big ball games when they had the regional tournament here a few years ago. It's been a jam-packed gymnasium. I do like the fact they have bleachers in the end zone to allow for bands to set up and things of that nature. We're about a minute and a half away from the start of the second half. Hank Bond, Keith Atkins here, and we'll be back with second half action in just a minute. You're watching Russell and Boyd County basketball on Green at Beacon and greenatbeacon2.com.
Choosing the right college is a big decision. Ohio University Southern offers more than 30 degree and certificate programs. Whether you're in Ohio or just across the river in Kentucky or West Virginia, our tuition is a best value in the area. Attend a world-class university and stay close to home with free parking. Ohio University Southern in Ironton and Proctorville. Imagine your possibilities. Enroll today. Visit ohio.edu/southern or call 740-533-4600.
At Meredith Chiropractic, you will enjoy state-of-the-art chiropractic facilities and discover the true wellness lifestyle. Dr. Terry Meredith is a member of Great Doctors of Chiropractic and has helped many in the Ashland area experience natural healing without surgery or drugs. If you're looking for a skilled chiropractic doctor, visit MeredithChiropractic.com, call 329-8158, or visit Dr. Meredith's office at 2120 Carter Avenue in Ashland.
A little tiny one, yep. 29-19, what do you think, Keith? What do you think?
Well, I believe it ought to be an interesting second half here.
Well, you know, Russell's made a couple runs at them.
They have, so. If they can get with them on the boards, I believe they have a shot here. Gaz and Thompson is tough underneath the boards for Boyd County, big old boys.
Physical,
yeah,
really are.
Physical.
Well, here we go. Back to work.
Back to work, he said.
Keith looks for every opportunity to sit down and enjoy the seat to my right, but now he's back on his feet. Ten-point lead for the Lions, and Boyd County will play right to left, and they'll inbound the ball to begin the second half. As we're ready to get underway now. At half, it's East Carter 39, Ashland 22. And that's the only score I have my hands on besides the big run on from by Brown County. Inside it goes to Gauze. He dribbles around, stump up, no good. Should have been a foul called, or was not. And out it comes to Russell. Hensley, timeline, kicks it over to Hale. Bobby Hale, Hensley at the guards, Raby on the far left. Brewer down underneath, along with Ryan Stump. Raby was wide open, they missed that one. He comes out, wide open at the top of the key. Cuts it down to a 7-point lead at 29-22. 7:17 to play. Russell tied it at 16. And then, again, it was tied at 20, but Boyd County's pulled out now to a 10-point lead at the half. Hale from, or not Hale, but Anderson. Rebound Thoson, no good. Rebound Brewer for Russell. Hensley tries to drive between two, and I think Evans. Yes, Evans drew that foul as he reached in. Made an effort to make a stab at it, and it just wasn't enough. And so out with it is Hensley. He drives, bounce pass inside the stump, nowhere to go. They kick it out to Hale for three, write it down. 29-25. In the corner, Rousey. On the baseline with it is Gauze. He gets a dribble, goes up, no good. There's going to be a foul called onside against Bobby Hale. First one up, no good, front of the rim. Boyd County a little cold on the inside as well. Sackleman no good. Rebound last touch by Brewer. And it came off of, he called it off Rousey, so it'll be Russell's ball. Hensley behind the back, pulls down, bounce past the stump on the baseline, guarded closely by Anderson, back out to Brewer. He won to three, he was wide open. Hale pulls up, nope, no shot, kicks it back out to Brewer. Brewer loses it, last touch there by Evans, but some sloppy ball handling was saved by the fact that Evans couldn't get a hand down. 29-24, Hensley with it against Evans. Tanner Evans. Hale. Hensley, left side to Raby, double team, comes back to Hensley. He jerks it away as Evans went for the steal. Hale goes for three, he hits it, and it's a 2-point lead now for Boyd County. After Russell drains its second three-pointer by Bobby Hale. 29-27. Anderson, Evans, Tanner Evans shoots it too hard. Nice rebound by Gauze. And they're going to call a body foul on Stump. I don't get that call. I mean, both of them were jockeying. I don't really get it. Three-pointer by Thoveson, no good, bounced off. Brewer gets it, almost knocked away there by Tanner Evans. Hensley out front, gives it to Stump. He almost falls down, double dribble. He walks with it. 29-27. Boyd County with a two-point lead and the ball back. It was a 10-point lead at half, down to two. In fact, Boyd County hadn't scored in the second half. 3.5 minutes in. Here's Rousey, that'll end. Three-pointer by Rousey as he shoots undefended from the corner. And it's a five-point lead now for Boyd County. Hale and Hensley around out front. Raby wide open for three. No good. Rim comes off to Thorfson. Touch last by Brewer. Nope, going to be touch last by Boyd County. Russell played it in. It'll be Raby. I thought Brewer put his fingers out there. Nope, he didn't touch it at all. Hensley. Foul. 32-27. Boyd County with it. The lead, Russell with the ball into Hensley. Down the lane, he wants a shot. Nope, gives it to Stump. Too hard. Brewer puts it up, foul from behind. Russell fans wanted a foul. Brewer with it, on the way, first one good. 4-point game, 32-28, 4 minutes to play exactly in quarter three. Second one up and in. Timeout on the floor. Oh, they called a lane violation, I guess, I don't know. 32-28. Tanner Evans, I kind of missed that call. But they ruled him over the line. 30-second timeout, step away and be back. This is Russell Basketball and Boyd County Ball on Greena Beacon and GreenaBeacon2.com.
Choosing the right college is a big decision. Ohio University Southern offers more than 30 degree and certificate programs. Whether you're in Ohio or just across the river in Kentucky or West Virginia, our tuition is a best value in the area. Attend a world-class university and stay close to home with free parking. Ohio University Southern in Ironton and Proctorville. Imagine your possibilities. Enroll today. Visit ohio.edu/southern or call 740-533-4600.
32-28. Boyd County with the lead and the ball under the Lions basket. It comes into Rousey. Reed Rousey over on the right-hand side. He dishes to the corner to Tanner Evans. Evans with it back to Rousey from downtown. No good. Rebound comes off to Boyd County. Thoveson. He'll put it up, and it's 34-28. So from a two-point lead to a six-point lead on a couple quick baskets. Boyd County with the lead, Russell with the ball. Rousey on Hensley. Tanner Evans goes for the steal. Right side it goes to Hensley. Hensley dumps it off to Brewer. He'll put it up and in. Brewer went around Gauze. And that cuts it to a four-point lead for Boyd with 2:57 to play. In the corner with it. Anderson back to Rousey. He hits a three. Nice shooting by the Lions. And Boyd County had trouble early on finding the basket, and now they're right back in control of their own destiny. Hensley double team coming up the floor. Tanner Evans knocked the ball away from behind. A bit of contact on the way up the sideline. Raby looks, throws it into Hensley. Anderson got a hand on Hensley. Now they're going to call the foul out front. Bobby Anderson with the foul. 37-30. Silas clocks in. Hensley to the bench. Boyd County with a 7-point lead. Five players out for Boyd County. Burnett, Priest, Dameron, and Taylor Smith out for Boyd County. 37-30. Hay on the corner to Cox, who took steps, no call. And ball went to Brewer, he was fouled. But it'll be a common foul. Fifth foul, I think. Foul on Smith, fourth foul. Up and in it goes by Raby, and it's a 5-point lead, 37-32. Burnett with the ball. Smith, quickly ahead it goes. Kendra, shot put up, no good, rebound, Boyd County. Kendra up and in on the rebound. Russell can't get their hands on the ball. And with that, Kendra gets a bucket, tapped it around a couple times, comes off, rebound to Brewer. A lot of body contact under the basket by both teams, out it goes. Here's a three from Cox, no good. You can tell from up here right away. Kendra throws it ahead to Smith. Burnett in the lane, back to Smith, unopposed three, good. Hale just should have had a step toward him and didn't. Timeout on the floor. 30-second timeout. We'll be back in a minute. This is Russell Basketball and Boyd County Ball on Green & Beacon and GreenAndBeacon2.com.
The fine people at Carmen Funeral Home have been working with families in need for over 100 years. Carmen Funeral Home offers compassionate and caring services to those in their time of need, from pre-arrangement to final arrangements. With two convenient locations in Flatwoods and Russell, Carmen Funeral Home, putting people first since 1913.
Brown County 42, Greenup County 9 at the half. Big 31-point lead. You'll have a running clock on that one very likely. And we're back here 42-32 after Russell had cut it to two. Lions have expanded the lead back out. Cox to stump, baseline Brewer, back it comes to Cox. Raby looking for the three, shoots a two, down too hard, rebound tapped around, control Brewer. Brewer gives it to Raby. Raby tried to square up, couldn't. Stump, baseline, he's going to get a block foul, and that foul called against Priest as he tried to impede his way to the basket. Cox, in it comes, stump, back to Cox. He'll bring it out front. He gets some pressure from Smith. Raby, should have been a double dribble. Picks it up, stolen away from behind him by Smith. And a foul on Brewer as he turned around. And so with 1:02 to play, foul on Brewer. Kyle Burnett will throw it in. Four fouls on the Red Devils. The Lions have five. 58 seconds to play quarter three. And a quickly played game here at Boyd County High School. From the corner downtown, no good. Off the back of the rim by Dameron. Rebound stump. Hensley, he had Brewer all the way down, but no way to get a pass to him. Cox gets a five count. Goes in, stolen away. This one's taken away by Kinzer. All the way down, shot it too hard. Tipped up and in by Hunter Priest, and now it's a 12-point game. And Boyd County with a big run. Dr. Round Brewer turns and puts it in, cuts it back to 10. 22 seconds to play in the third quarter. And out of bounds goes Brock Dameron. Hunter Williams will come in, send Cox to the bench. And so 16 seconds to play, quarter three. Ethan Raby comes into Hensley. He sets a pick in the corner. Stump had the shot. Hensley, he'll pull, give it to Williams. It's off the glass too hard. Rebound comes off. 3 seconds, two from midcourt. Oh, what a shot! What a shot! So, 47-34. That'll be a clip you can pull out of that one, Coach. 47-34. We're at the third stop. We'll be back here in a minute on greenatbeacon.com.
I'm Julie Reeves. You're watching Green at Beacon.com, a member of the Beacon Media Group.
Play underway here in quarter four. Hunter Williams in the lane, kicks it to the baseline to Stump. Comes back out to Raby. A two, no good, too short. Comes up Williams. He looks in the lane, goes, puts it off the glass and in. 47-36. Cuts it to a 11-point lead. That will be an 11-point lead. Down the lane, up and in. No, we're good. Rebound put back up. Boyd County knocks it around. They control it. Over there is Burnett with the ball. Comes across out front to Dameron. Back to Burnett. Burnett will be picked up by Hunter Williams. Williams takes him to the left. Gets picked off. Here's a shot from the corner. Finally, by Dameron. Dameron struggled early on, but I think he's found it now. And it's 50-36, a 14-point lead for the homestanding Lions here at Summit Middle School, or Boyd County Middle School in Summit. In the lane, gives it off, up and in. Assist Hensley, Landon Brewer with the basket, and it's a 12-point lead, 6:46 to play. Russell trailing by 12 and now by 14. Hunter Priest with a nice lay-in, a nice spinning layup, and it's, I think Dameron had the assist on that. Ahead it comes to Hunter Williams. Boyd County with a lot of pressure, tapped away, but they're going to call a foul this time on Burnett. And that's a sixth foul. Williams to the bench. So we have Hale, Hensley, Raby, Brewer, and Stump for Russell. And we'll try to pick up Boyd County out here in a minute. I see Smith. That shot's a three. Write that one down. Hensley. Boyd County turns it over. So Hensley got a three to make it an 11-point game, and Russell gets it back. And out there is Kinzer, who's three for Boyd County. One is Burnett. 22 is Dameron. 13 is Smith. And I'm missing one number. We'll pick it up in a minute. 34 is Priest. Kinzer, Burnett, Priest, Dameron, and Smith, I think. Raby shot it just a little hard. Nice rebound, tapped around, controls Stump, gives it to Brewer, comes back out to Hale. They clear out and Russell set it up again. Russell with a shot opportunity underneath, could not control the ball. Hale in the corner, Raby for three. Got to hit him, no good. Rebound that comes off to Kinzer. Kinzer double team, but he gets it off to Burnett. Burnett runs quickly up the floor, goes to Dameron. Dameron cross courts it to Smith. Smith from three, too hard. Rebound, Boyd County up, Priest, and he's fouled. Hey, Sam, gotta call those both ways, you know. Need to call those both ways, you know. Free throw up, rolls in. I have no problem that that was a foul, but you gotta call it on both ends. So,
you got some big bodies in there battling, and they don't call none.
Silas Cox will check in for Russell. Four out for Boyd County. And the fifth one will check in. Thorson will check in for Priest if he hits it. Raby sits down on the far bench. And it's no good, so he stays in for a minute. Ball on the floor, fought four, rolled around, picked up Hale. Hale comes out, he'll run it up, throws it up ahead to Cox. Cox on the baseline, cross courts it to Hensley. Hensley gets it, he's fouled on the way up, and he'll shoot two. And Thorson will check in after the first free throw. Hensley with a couple. First one up, rolls it out. So Thorson will check in, or Thorson will check in for Boyd County, and to the bench goes Priest. So the second five, or the top starting five, out for Boyd County now, leading by 12. No good on the second free throw. And it'll be Reed Rousey to handle it. He gives it back to Anderson. Rousey on the right side. Anderson out front, back to Rousey. He wanted to shoot that three. He'll keep it. He comes back out to Evans. Left side to Anderson. In the lane it goes. Thorson free throw line. Nope, they'll kick it around. Three from Evans. No good. Rebound stump. Russell with the rebound. He gets some pressure from Reed Rousey. And it'll be Bobby Hale who'll cross the timeline. Picked up there by Anderson. He gives it to Hensley. Anderson stays on Hensley. 4-on-4 as we see it. Go across the top of the key. Quick call. Nope. No whistle. And it comes out. Goes to Hensley. Fake stops. Puts a shot up and in. Nice move. Fake right. Went left. Kind of like a little jab there. 53-43. It's a 10-point game. After a 14-point lead at the third stop for Boyd County. Russell with 4 1/4, but there's Rousey too hard. It comes back to Thoveson, and he puts it in from the free throw line. It's a 12-point lead, 55-43. Boyd County able to get that one down. There it goes. Brewer in, puts it up. Nope, didn't get it to fall, but he does draw the foul on Connor Gauze. Another one of those little tippy fouls. So Brewer will have a couple. Say hello to our buddy Jack Fannin in Florida. I'm sure he's gathered around his computer. Told me he would be this evening. Occasionally I get emails and messages during the game, but not so tonight. Rebound, Boyd County. Rousey with it. Gives it to Anderson. Here we go. Foul call underneath on Gauze. Russell under pressure. Stump, he's going to get a foul. You know, up 12 points, I don't think I'd foul. So that puts Russell in the double bonus. So Russell has a chance to score some points with the clock stop. Stump hits it. He'll get his second. And in the air, high it goes. Hits the back of the rim. Rebound, Thorson. Boyd County with an 11-point lead. In the lane it goes. Offensive foul called on Connor Gauze. I don't think Randy Anderson was too happy about that call. He did kind of lower his shoulder just a little bit. But heretofore, those fouls have been called on the defense. So in it comes to Hensley, quickly ahead to Stump. Stump drives down, pulls in, pulls out. We're going to bounce it to Brewer. Nope, gives it to Hensley. Hensley back to Stump. Stump baseline, going to call a charge. And Stump put his arm out, pushed him down. And so that'll be an offensive foul, 55-44. 3:22 to play in the game. Cox and Priest in. Cox for Russell, Priest for Boyd County. That's five fouls on Stump. So Stump picked up a couple fouls early that hurt him now, and so he's out. Timeout on the floor, full timeout. We'll step away and be back. This is Russell Basketball and Boyd County Ball on GreenandBeacon.com.
Hi, I'm Julie Reeves. You're watching Green at Beacon.com, a member of the Beacon Media Group.
55-44, Boyd County with the lead and the ball. 3:13 to play in regulation. Rousey inside, it goes to Priest. Priest can't handle it, but he draws a foul. And I think they're going to call that on Bobby Hale. Nope. They're going to call it on Landon Brewer. Brewer can't get a break. But they're down there and we're up here. Thanks again to Pete Fraley and the Boyd County Administration, Mr. Himes, the principal, for allowing us to stream these games here, and to Russell. And of course, Russell, Anna Chafin, and Sam Sparks. They've always taken pretty good care of us. And we're glad to be here with you, and we hope you've enjoyed tonight's game. Still relatively close, 12 points. And Hensley fakes right, goes left, gives it to Cox. Russell basically moving it around, looking for the shot. Raby kicks it to Hale. Hale for three, too hard. Off the far side of the rim, rebound controlled by Russell. Gives it to Raby, up and in. Down to 10, 56-46. And then his score updates in a few minutes. I guess we'll get him in a minute. In the lane. Should have been Steps, didn't call it. Thoveson with a nice layup to the left hand. And it's 58-46. Tap quickly there by Tanner Evans. And it could have been a turnover had he been a step closer. But he does knock it out. Russell will get a new 10-second count. 58-46, 2:21 to play. Brewer. Gives it back to Hale. Bounce over to Hensley. Hensley with it in the lane. Knocked away. Ball goes out of bounds. As people begin to leave right in front of us, we have a little trouble with this one. It'll be Russell's ball. I guess they kicked it. I didn't see it. 56-13 round over Greenup County. Third quarter. Of course, the running clock there. Oh, Hale missed a nice running jump shot. Picks it up, puts it back up. It's blocked out, controlled by Priest. Priest gives the ball off to Anderson. And Boyd County with it quickly. Anderson down, should be going to call a block on Hale, but that really was I don't know. He lowered his shoulder a little bit, so I don't know. Of course, Hale was not set at all, so that'll be five for Hale. So two Red Devils to the bench. Hunter Williams out. One and one. At the line, Anderson hits it. Timeout, Boyd County. He'll take a full timeout. Be sure to enter our Chick-fil-A contest at hank@greenabeacon.com. Ron County leads Greenup County. At the end of three, it's East Carter 53, Ashland 31. 22-point lead for the Raiders. And here it's 60-46 Boyd County. Shot up by Hunter Williams. Double dribble.
He hit it.
Ball comes in to Burnett. Took minute 36 to play. Burnett guarded by Williams. Williams takes him down to the baseline. Back out it comes. Burnett gives it to Gauze. Gauze against Brewer. Brewer tries to block him, going to charge. As he pushed his way to the basket. Offensive foul called against Gauze. That's five fouls on Gauze.
Fouls on Boyd County, 755. That is his fifth personal foul.
Randy Anderson will send Hunter Priest in for Gauze, and that's five for the big man for Boyd County. I don't think the Boyd County bench is very happy with that call. Assistance up along with Anderson. Football pass ahead to Brewer. He handled it nicely all the way down. Had a flop by Priest. They let it go by. 60-48. Anderson drives all the way down, puts a reverse up, no good. Rebound comes off, Russell with it, Hensley. Hensley looks underneath, up, stolen away. Reed Rousey takes it all the way down. He'll throw it up, going to count the basket. Foul on the way in. That foul's going to be called against Silas Cox. His second. 48 seconds to play. Final margin is what's in doubt here. Ball out of bounds, gonna call a foul. Williams turned around, didn't go for the ball, used his body and knocked to the floor, went Tanner Evans. Two shots. Evans can stretch this lead out. 14, make it now 15-point lead for Boyd County. Russell had gotten down under 10. It was a 13-point lead after three. Second one rolls around, comes off. Anytime it goes around twice, it'll come out because it spins up. There's a layup. No good. Rebound, Boyd County. Russell won't foul to get the ball. 15-point lead. Little defense. Anderson or Rousey goes down in the corner. Burnett, he'll do a reverse layup, puts it in. So it's a 17-point game. A little deceptive on the final score. Hensley, here's the ball. Bounce pass underneath. Tried to go to Raby, couldn't. And Anderson will control with 12 seconds to play. 8 seconds to play. Both teams will line up. Boyd County hold the ball, the game's over. And there's the final score. 65 for Boyd County and 48 for Russell. And we'll step away and be back in a minute. This is Russell Basketball, Green and Beacon, and greenandbeacon2.com with the Boyd County Line.
I go to Ashland Community and Technical College.
Because it's so close.
I go
for the small class sizes.
I go
because I can transfer my credits.
I go because
I can take classes when it works for me.
I go to get a better job.
I go for some of Kentucky's most affordable tuition.
I go because it's crazy not to.
For all the right reasons, Ashland Community and Technical College. Higher education begins here.
Visit the Sungate Alpaca Company to experience the vibrant cultural heritage of South America and discover the extraordinary luxury fabric called alpaca. Wrap yourself in a stylish alpaca scarf, transform your living room by adding texture and color with a hand-loomed alpaca throw blanket, and add a little extra warmth and cozy fashion with an alpaca hat and matching gloves. Visit sungatealpaca.com for all your alpaca needs. Find us on Facebook for special deals and inventory updates. Shop Sungate Alpaca.
Has six convenient locations to serve you. From South Shore to the main office, First and People's Bank has been serving this area with complete banking services since 1932. Visit the home office near you, First and People's Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
We are the home office. Come visit any of our six locations.
Final score here at Boyd County Middle was Russell losing to the Boyd County Lions 65, and the Red Devils dropped to 5-17 on the year, as the Lions have a region best 18-3 record. I don't have any more score updates for you, but unless there's some radical change, East Carter will take a win over Ashland. And Round County will defeat Greenham County here in the play tonight in boys action. I don't have any other scores for you. I know that Lewis County was playing tonight. I believe Raceland maybe down at Lewis County because of it snowed out or something. I think they delayed it the other day. I may be confused, but anyway, not a lot of action reported. There may be some games tonight. Anyway, the final score, after Boyd County took a 13-10 lead, Russell tied it up at 16-16. Actually, had led at one point 16-13. Boyd County pulled out 20-16. Russell stayed close. It was 29-19 at the half. Russell cut it to a 5-point lead, but trailed by 13 after three. And then Boyd County able to control it and hang on to pull away to the 17-point win. You can join Keith Adkins. I don't know when it is.
We'll be back together the 30th of
Russell. Okay. Friday night will be Russell and Greenup County on greenupbeacon.com. And it's also available on greenupbeacon2.com, but it is not the primary game there. And then on Saturday night, again, I believe Russell plays again. I don't know if you play on Saturday or not. You do.
We're together Friday
and Saturday night. So it'll be Bath County and Russell Girls, and that will be an exciting game for the Red Devils. So I know some of the people from Bath County, so it'll be an exciting night of basketball. Again, the final score here was Boyd County 65, now 18-3 on the year. Russell scored 48, falling to 5-17. For Keith Adkins, this is Hank Bond. We thank you for joining us here on greenandbeacon.com, and we'll be back on the air again Friday afternoon. Don't forget to join us tomorrow at 1 o'clock for Green and Beacon Video News Magazine here on Green and Beacon and greenandbeacon2.com, all members of the Beacon Media Group.
Russell High School Sports on greenandbeacon.com. This live video streaming webcast is an exclusive presentation by the Green and Beacon and First in People's Bank and Trust. Russell Sports Action is also brought to you by Ohio University Southern, Our Lady of Bellefonte Hospital, Carmen Funeral Home, Stultz Pharmacy, Meredith Chiropractic, Ashland Community and Technical College, and the Sungate Alpaca Company. Russell Sports on greenatbeacon.com and its webcast team, Hank Bond, Keith Adkins, Brittany Hoback, Ryan Yearout, Evan Tice, and Kristen Keaton.